Isaiah chapter 30. Woe to the obstinate children, declares the Lord, to those who carry out plans that are not mine, forming an alliance, but not by my spirit, heaping sin upon sin, who go down to Egypt without consulting me, who look for help to Pharaoh's protection, to Egypt's shade for refuge. Now you remember Egypt. Egypt is a nation of the mind and heart. It is a nation where man decides he's going to play God. But Pharaoh's protection will be to your shame. Egypt's shade will bring you disgrace. Though they have officials in Zoan, and their envoys have arrived in Haines, all the diplomats, everyone will be put to shame because of a people useless to them, who bring neither help nor advantage, but only shame and disgrace in the end. An oracle concerning the animals of the Negev. The Negev is the wilderness, even where John the Baptist and where Jesus. John the Baptist came out of the wilderness and Jesus went into the wilderness. Through a land of hardship and distress, of lions and lionesses. Remember, these animals are all indicative to characters in people. Of adders and darting snakes. The envoys carry their riches on donkeys' backs, their treasures on the humps of camels, to that unprofitable nation, to Egypt, whose help is utterly useless. Man is not God. Man can't save anything. Therefore, I call her Rahab, the do-nothing. Go now, write it on a tablet for them, inscribe it on a scroll, that for the days to come it may be an everlasting witness. These are rebellious people, deceitful children, children unwilling to listen to the Lord's instructions. They say to the seers, "See no more visions." And to the prophets, give us no more visions of what is right. See what the prophets should be talking about? They should be showing us what is right. Not forecasting the future. Tell us pleasant things. Prophesy illusions. Leave this way. Get off this path. And stop confronting us with the Holy One of Israel. They don't like talking about Jesus. They say, oh no, we already know about Jesus. We want other stuff. Interesting. Everything hinges on Jesus the Christ. Everything. Including prophecy. Therefore, this is what the Holy One of Israel says. Because you have rejected this message, relied on oppression, and depended on deceit, this sin will become for you like a high wall, cracked and bulging, that collapses suddenly in an instant. I won't prove it here. I'll only say this. This is the fall of Mystery Babylon, which is organized religion. It will break in pieces like pottery, shattered so mercilessly that among its pieces not a fragment will be found for taking coals from a hearth or scooping water out of a cistern. This is what the Sovereign Lord, the Holy One of Israel, says. In repentance and rest is your salvation. In quietness and trust is your strength. But you would have none of it. You said, no, we will flee on horses. Remember horses? They're that which carries us from point A to point B, carries our opinions, our ideologies. Therefore you will flee. You said, we will ride off on swift horses. Therefore your pursuers will be swift. 1,000 will flee at the threat of one. At the threat of 5, you will all flee away, till you are left like a flagstaff on a mountaintop, like a banner on a hill. Yet the Lord longs to be gracious to you. He rises to show you compassion. For the Lord is a God of justice. Blessed are all who wait for him. O people of Zion, who live in Jerusalem. Zion is the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is within you, and the new Jerusalem is the bride of Christ. Take that into consideration. O people of Zion, who live in Jerusalem, you will weep no more. How gracious he will be when you cry for help. As soon as he hears, he will answer you. Although the Lord gives you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, your teachers will be hidden no more. With your own eyes you will see them. Whether you turn to the right or to the left, your ears will hear a voice behind you saying, "This is the way, walk in it." Truth, Jesus is God in an attitude of love. Then you will defile your idols overlaid with silver and your images covered with gold. All those things that matter to you other than Jesus and love. You will throw them away like a menstrual cloth and say to them, "Away with you." He will also send you rain for the seed you sow in the ground. Remember the rain of understanding? Remember the seed is the word of God? And the food that comes from the land will be rich and plentiful. In that day, your cattle will graze in the broad meadows. Remember your cattle? I'm not trying to be funny, but the Orthodox Jew calls the cattle the goyim. They're men. The oxen and donkeys that work the soil. Remember the oxen? Those with understanding preach the truth. Remember the donkeys? They can work. They're valuable. Stubborn, though. Ooh, bronze foreheads. Very stubborn. You never harness an ox and a donkey together, because the donkey will make the oxes work so hard that nothing will get done. That work the soil will eat fodder and mash spread out with fork and shovel. In the day of great slaughter, oh crap, that's Armageddon. That's Topeth, that's Ben-Hinnom. That's Joel's Valley of Decision. In the day of great slaughter when the towers fall, remember the towers? They're all those great bastions of what we call justice, liberty, freedom, righteousness. Streams of water will flow on every high mountain and every lofty hill. The moon will shine like the sun. Remember, the sun is the sun of righteousness. The moon is the faithful witness in the night. The Christ, it's Jesus. The sunlight will be 7 times brighter. Remember the sevenfold spirit of God that surrounds the throne of righteousness? Like the light of 7 full days when the Lord binds up the bruises of his people and heals the wounds he inflicted. See, the name of the Lord comes from afar. Pay attention now. The name of the Lord comes from afar. That's what we should be listening for. With burning anger and dense clouds of smoke, his lips are full of wrath, and his tongue is a consuming fire. Remember the fire of God? It's the truth revealed. Remember the sword that proceeds from the mouth? It's the sword of truth. His breath is like a rushing torrent, rising up to the neck. He shakes the nations in the sieve of destruction. He places in the jaws of the people a bit that leads them astray. And you will sing as on the night you celebrate a holy festival. Your hearts will rejoice as when people go up with flutes to the mountain of the Lord, to the rock of Israel. The Lord will cause men to hear his majestic voice and will make them see his arm coming down with raging anger and consuming fire, with cloudburst, thunderstorm, and hail. The voice of the Lord will shatter Assyria. Remember Assyria? That's might makes right, military strength. With his scepter he will strike them down. Every stroke the Lord lays on them with his punishing rod. Remember the rod of God? Again, it's the truth, the word. Punishing rod will be to the music of tambourines and harps as he fights them in battle with the blows of his arm. Every time another truth is revealed. What happens when you think you've got life all figured out? When you think you've got a handle on everything? And all of a sudden, along comes the truth. And it just so happens that you didn't have a handle on nothing. What you thought was right is wrong, and what you thought was everything you thought. It's just no logical sense whatsoever. It's revealed and it's obvious that it's just stupidity. It's not right. What happens? You feel good? You hear the thunder? You know? You hear the people talking about, are there really two sides to wisdom in the Bible? Have you heard that preached? You know, people talking about this, that, you know, thorns and thistles are malicious neighbors, and that's what the crown of thorns represented when they made one and planted on its head. It's a picture of maliciousness against the king's head. You heard about that kind of stuff, you know, the bestiary, you know, and all, everything means something different. I wonder if there's any truth to that. You hear the thunder? The thunder's in the word, you know, in Revelation where he talks, the Lord's revealing all of this to John, and he says to John, don't write down what the thunders say. Let them figure it out for themselves. It's there. Topheth has long been prepared. Remember Topheth, that's Bozrah, that's the Valley of Slaughter, that's Armageddon. It has been made ready for the king. Its fire pit has been made deep and wide with an abundance of fire and wood. And remember the fire of the wood, fire and wood? Look up this. The breath of the Lord, like a stream of burning sulfur, sets it ablaze. This is Isaiah chapter 30. But, boy, this is talking about the end of days, isn't it? Yeah, sure it is. Sure it is. So what can I tell you about what is going on in the world today? Well, one thing I can tell you is that what's happening in the world today has nothing to do with the pandemic. Nothing. What's happening in the world today has nothing to do with the superpowers, Russia, China, the United States, whoever else wants to join in, fighting against each other for supremacy, for democracy, for communism, whatever. Nothing to do with it. What's going on in the world today has nothing to do with the U.S. elections and who's going to be president and who's not. Got nothing to do with it. Remember I told you, everything hinges on Christ. It sure doesn't hinge on who's going to be the next president of the United States. It has nothing to do with the New World Order, and it has nothing to do with the Great Reset. It's all foolishness. It's got nothing to do with that. It has nothing to do with the Vatican. Nothing. Who's the Pope? What's the Pope? Nothing to do with that. It has nothing to do with Israel over in Israel on a map, over in the Holy Land. Got nothing to do with them, that nation. Nothing. people said, oh boy, I tell you, you know, Israel, 1948, regained nationhood. It was all prophesied was going to come and everything. It's got nothing to do with the end of days. Nothing. The Israel of God is not a people who live on a place on a map or practice a particular organized religion. There come a day, Jesus told us, you won't worship in this city or on this mountain. You'll worship in mind and heart, to truth and love, wherever you stand on planet Earth. You'll worship God in here and in here. Not all who are called Israel are Israel. Remember that. And yes, it does say that all Israel will be saved. But not all Israel are what are called Israel, or what calls themselves Israel. The Israel of God is those circumcised in mind and heart to truth and love. Period. Who are they? What color are they? Every color. They were all over the world. These are the ones the Father seeks, those who worship in spirit, in love, and in truth. Jesus is Lord. Now there's a little portion of scripture. Let's go to Jeremiah 4 and 4. It says, circumcise yourselves to the Lord. Circumcise your hearts, O men of Judah and people of Jerusalem, or my wrath will break out and burn like fire because of the evil you have done. Burn with no one to quench it. You won't put out the fire of God. No one can. Let's go to Jeremiah 23. Woe to the shepherds. It doesn't say woe to the pagans, or to the wicked, or to the righteous. It says woe to the shepherds. Shepherds look after sheep, who are destroying and scattering the sheep of my pasture, declares the Lord. Woe to the shepherds. Remember how we were warned? I think it's in James. It'll be on the screen here. Not many should presume to teach. Not many. You best know what you're talking about before you open your mouth and start flapping your gums about what you think. You better have proof. From the Word. From the Bible. Two or three witnesses. With no contradictions of other portions of Scripture. Because those who teach will be judged much more strictly than those who listen. Therefore, this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says to the shepherds who tend my people. Because you have scattered my flock, what? And driven them away. Wasn't it the wolves who scattered the sheep? Yeah. Weren't we warned the wolves who come in amongst us? Yeah, they do. They feed on us, you know. Yeah, send me your tithe, that's mine, you know. Yeah, they feed on us, they make money off us and everything. Never bothering to explain to anybody what the tithe is and how much of it is theirs. Because only 33.3% of the tithe, the 10% tithe, belongs to them. The rest belongs to you. Yeah, I got videos on it. It's in Deuteronomy. Look up the tithe. Find out what you do with it, where it goes. And have not bestowed care upon my sheep. I will bestow punishment on you for the evil you have done. That should scare the bejesus out of any clown who thinks he wants to stand up and teach in a pulpit, on the internet, anywhere. You best know what you're talking about, son. I myself will gather the remnant of my flock out of all the countries where I have driven them, and I will bring them back to their pasture where they will be fruitful and increase in number. I will place shepherds over them who will tend them, and they will no longer be afraid or terrified, nor will any be missing, declares the Lord. The days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will raise up to David a righteous branch, a king who will reign wisely and do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved, and Israel will live in safety. This is the name by which he will be called: the Lord, our righteousness. Man is not God. So then, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when people will no longer say, as surely as the Lord lives, who brought the Israelites up out of Egypt, but they will say, as surely as the Lord lives, who brought the descendants of Israel up out of the land of the north and out of all the countries where he had banished them. Then they will live in their own land. Concerning the prophets, now this is where I'm pointing at tonight. My heart is broken within me. All my bones tremble. I am like a drunken man, like a man overcome by wine, because of the Lord and his holy words. So his words are going to be confusing, aren't they? Just in case you're connecting any dots, these are the scorpions. Remember the scorpions with stings in their tails? Tails are lying prophets, and they have stings in them like scorpions. They sting a man, they send him into, like the sting of a scorpion. Well, research what happens when a scorpion stings you. Well, you hallucinate. That's what happens. And what does it say here? My heart is broken within me, all my bones tremble. I am like a drunken man, like a man overcome by wine, because of the Lord and his holy words. The land is full of adulterers. Remember adultery, right? You know, the great whore, Mystery Babylon, she's called a whore. She's also called a prostitute, and she's also called a great adulteress. Well, it's all in reference to the same thing. Organized religion has an awful tendency to claim that they know God, that their organized religion points at the one, or at God. It doesn't have to be the one true God, because it's not just Christianity. It's all religions all over the world are whores. They claim to teach the people what they need to know and everything about God, and where God is and where he came from and where he's going. And they all have their prophets and everything, and it's all BS. The land is full of adulterers. Well, an adulterer then, if you claim to be the betrothed of God, and God is truth, operating in a spirit of love, and you choose a false God, thereby revealing your hatred of truth, that's not love. You're a whore. That's simple. It's that simple. And I'm not just pointing at Christendom here. I'm pointing at all the organized religion on the planet. That even includes the atheists' organized religion. Because they got their own little band of brothers, boy, and their religion, what they think is divine, and what they follow as demanded by what they think is divine, that's their God. Most of the time, it's them, themselves. They think man is God. They think they're God. What is because they made it that way. Not because any God had anything to do with it. Yeah, right. Or science. Same thing. You know, what we discover makes us gods. Our technology becomes our God. But really, it's their ability to utilize that technology. That is their God, therefore it's still them claiming their God. All religions on the face of the earth are going to taste and they're all going to burn, including Christendom, including Judaism, including Hindus and Muslims and you name it. All of it, all organized religion is going to burn big time. The land is full of adulterers because of the curse. The land lies parched and the pastures in the desert are withered. The prophets follow an evil course. Their course, of course, is they follow the knowledge of good and evil. They read the scriptures and they think that, well, if it's good, then it's from the tree of life. And if it's evil, then it's from the devil. Mm-mm. The knowledge of good and evil is a separate tree all by itself. The tree of life is over here, not over there. Period. Don't start thinking that the knowledge of good and evil has anything to do with the tree of life, because it doesn't. But when people don't understand the gift of understanding, which comes from the tree of life, it's in 1 John 5 and 20, this is the gift of the Spirit. The Spirit is God. God is Spirit. And this Spirit we call God is truth. And the Spirit of truth is love. That's the understanding that comes from the tree of life. The knowledge of good and evil, that's offered by the devil. But these prophets who follow an evil course and use their power unjustly, both prophet and priest are godless. They don't know God. Oh, they preach in Jesus' name and they claim Jesus is the Christ and everything else. They don't know what it means to call Jesus the Christ. They have no idea. They have no idea. Oh, he's the Messiah. Yeah, it's a lot more than that. But they don't understand. They don't recognize God as truth. Invisible, but eternal. The creator of all things everywhere. If everything that is created was destroyed, truth would have been the one who destroyed it. And truth would still exist. Truth existed before anything. Truth has no beginning and no end. Truth is eternal. And love is the spirit of truth. There's your Christ. But both prophet and priest are godless, even in my temple. Even in my temple. Remember the temple? It's in the kingdom. The kingdom's within you. The capital city of the kingdom is the New Jerusalem. The temple is in the New Jerusalem. The New Jerusalem is the bride of Christ. And the temple within the New Jerusalem is, yeah, it's us. Even in my temple, I find their wickedness, declares the Lord. Therefore, their path will become slippery. They will be banished to darkness. And there they will fall. They're on their way to the lake of fire. I will bring disaster on them in the year they are punished, declares the Lord. This is really scary stuff. And if it isn't to you, something's wrong. You're just not believing what the word says. Among the prophets of Samaria, I saw this repulsive thing. They prophesied by Baal and led my people Israel astray. You know who Baal is, eh? Baal is man playing God. Your priest, your prophet, your rabbi could be your Baal. Oh, I believe what the pastor says. That's got to be right. I don't believe in anything else. Try the Bible. Try believing what God has to say about it. But no, they want to follow their Baals. Those in authority. My president said this, so I'm going to go with that. What he says is right. Really? You think so? I think I'd test what he says against what God says, the same as I test the pastors and the priests and the rabbis against what God says in his word. before I fall for believing them. And among the prophets of Jerusalem, I have seen something horrible. They commit adultery and live a lie. They climb into bed with falsehood and hatred and copulate with the devil and claim to be the bride of Christ, who is truth and love and is one and only ever begotten bodily form. A bunch of whores. Organized, I've told you over and over, 10 years I've been telling you, organized religion is Mystery Babylon. They strengthen the hands of evildoers so that no one turns from his wickedness, because they don't show people who God is. That's why. If you know who God is and you understand who God is, do you practice what you preach? They don't teach that. They are all like Sodom to me. What did God do to Sodom? He destroyed it. The people of Jerusalem are like Gomorrah. What did he do to Gomorrah? He destroyed it. And rightfully so. Rightfully so. Truth and love did not exist in those cities. God was not served in those cities. I'm going to say it here just for the sake of saying it. It's the truth, so. You can't mate two males and create life. You can't mate two females and create life. The truth dictates you mate a male and a female to create life. They don't even follow that very simple principle and rule. They don't even follow that. Oh, but we love each other. Yeah, in perversion. You can't claim to know or follow God if you walk in that kind of crap. And don't give me the bullshit that, well, I can't help myself. Yeah, you can. I lost my wife 20 years ago. And I haven't had sex or masturbated in 20 years. If I can do it, you can do it. But you pick the God you want to serve, don't you? Therefore, this is what the Lord says concerning the prophets. I will make them eat bitter food and drink poisoned water. Because from the prophets of Jerusalem, ungodliness has spread throughout the entire land. This is what the Lord Almighty says. Do not listen to what the prophets are prophesying to you. They fill your head with false hopes. They speak visions from their own minds, not from the mouth of the Lord. They keep saying to those who despise me, the Lord says, you will have peace. And to all who follow the stubbornness of their own hearts, they say, no harm will come to you. You want to bet? You want to bet no harm will come to you? It'll come. But which of them has stood in the counsel of the Lord to see or to hear his word? We're back to the Bible, aren't we? We're back to truth and an attitude of love. Who has listened and heard his word? See, the storm of the Lord will burst out in wrath, a whirlwind swirling down on the heads of the wicked. The anger of the Lord will not turn back until he fully accomplishes the purpose of his heart. Remember what it says? My word never falls void to the ground without accomplishing the task for which it was sent. Remember that, Christians. Don't be afraid to speak the truth. In days to come, you will understand it clearly. I did not send these prophets, yet they have run with their message. I did not speak to them, yet they have prophesied. But if they had stood in my counsel, says the Lord, they would have proclaimed my word to my people and would have turned my people from their evil ways and from their evil deeds. Am I only a God nearby, declares the Lord, and not a God far away? Can anyone hide in secret places so that I cannot see him, declares the Lord? Do I not fill heaven and earth? Declares the Lord. Can you go anywhere where truth doesn't exist? Where truth is not right there with you? Urging you to love? Even when your conscience is seared shut, where you won't listen to truth anymore, where you won't love anymore, don't you still hear him calling? Yeah, sure you do. You just won't listen anymore. I have heard what the prophets say who prophesy lies in my name. Remember, these are prophets who are prophesying lies in Jesus' name, in God's name. They say, I had a dream, I had a dream. Yeah, that's a lot of good, eh? How long will this continue in the hearts of these lying prophets who prophesied the delusions of their own minds? Remember what it says somewhere about what is grain got to do with straw? Straw being their dreams and their delusions, their stupid opinions that don't line up with the word. That's not grain. You don't feed people straw. They'll die. They think the dreams they tell one another will make my people forget my name. Oh, there's that. Don't forget his name. It is the most important thing you will ever hear about. Everything hinges on Christ Jesus. Just as their fathers forgot my name through Baal worship. Yeah, they started worshiping the man instead of worshiping God, truth and love. Let the prophet who has a dream tell his dream, but let the one who has my word speak it faithfully. For what is straw to do with grain? There it is. Is not my word like a fire? Like fire, I should say, declares the Lord. Like a hammer that breaks a rock in pieces. Therefore, declares the Lord, I am against the prophets who steal from one another words supposedly from me. Yes, declares the Lord, I am against the prophets who wag their own tongues and yet declare, the Lord declares.
The God told me. Jesus told me.
No, I didn't. Everything he has to say is in this book. Everything. And he has nothing else to say. So if God told you that Donald Trump was going to win, or that Donald Trump was going to lose and Biden was going to win, you're full of shit. It's just that simple. Because they got nothing to do with this. Indeed, I am against those who prophesied false dreams, declares the Lord. They tell them and lead my people astray with their reckless lies. Yet I did not send or appoint any of them. They do not benefit these people in the least, declares the Lord. When these people or a prophet or a priest ask you, what is the oracle of the Lord? Say to them, what oracle? I will forsake you, declares the Lord. If a prophet or a priest or anyone else claims this is the oracle of the Lord, I will punish that man and his household. If you can't point to Scripture and have the Scriptures reveal what you want to say, and instead you let people think that you're something special. Nobody's special. I'm not special. You're not special. We're just worms crawling around on this filthy earth that's so polluted with lies, hate, deceit. Think we're special? Now turn around and say, well, thus saith the Lord. Don't do that. Don't do that. You know who I'm talking to right now. You love to do that. You got your beard long and your hair and everything, and you got your little shawl, and you're on there saying, thus saith the Lord. Be careful, brother. God won't put up with it. You will come to regret playing that game. You're no prophet of God. Period. That's not something God has gifted you with. I will punish that man and his household. So you're not just hurting yourself. You're hurting your whole household. This is what each of you keeps on saying to his friend and relative. What is the Lord's answer? or what has the Lord spoken? But you must not mention the oracle of the Lord again, because every man's own word becomes his oracle, and so you distort the words of the living God. Let the word of God say what the word of God has already said. Don't put words in God's mouth. The Lord God Almighty, our God, this is what you keep saying to a prophet. What is the Lord's answer to you? Or what has the Lord spoken? Although you claim this is the oracle of the Lord, this is what the Lord says. You use the words, this is the oracle of the Lord, even though I warned you that you must not claim anything is the oracle of the Lord. Therefore, I will surely forget you and cast you out of my presence, along with the city I gave to you and your fathers. I will bring upon you everlasting disgrace, everlasting shame, that will not be forgotten. Let's go to Jeremiah. Yeah, come on here. Where is it, Jeremiah? 5:13. You remember, he's just given quite a discourse about what he has to say about the lying prophets. Here's what he says. The prophets are but wind, and the word is not in them. So let what they say be done to them. That's one scary thing. And if you can't see it, you're blind. The Lord says, let what the lying prophets say be done to them. It won't affect us at all. Those who know the truth, acknowledge the truth, and live by the truth are willing to give up everything for the sake, let everything go for the sake of love. No, we either walk with Jesus or we gawk against him. Jesus walks in love. He doesn't walk in hate or contempt or slander or backbiting, or he walks in love. And if we're not willing to do the same, well, then we're choosing not to follow him. And here he is saying that these prophets who tell all their lies and their bullshit, let what they say happen to them. You will see her burning. She's gonna catch fire like you never imagined possible. And when we look at this whore burning, being destroyed, just like Sodom and Gomorrah was being destroyed, think about it. Is an awful lot of people who put their faith in organized religion. Hell, there's a lot of saints in organized religion. But isn't that what the word tells us? Yeah. Yep. Bodies and the blood of the saints are in her. There's a tent peg in scripture. Google the tent peg. You'll quickly figure out who it is. It is Jesus. And scripture tells us that tent peg's going to shear off. Do you see what happens when it shears off? People who have put their faith in their religion, their organized religion, their doctrine and rituals and rules and regulations and festivals and ceremony and all that kind of stuff, and think they're serving God in doing so, while they behave like commoners on the street, like unbelievers the rest of the time. When they're amongst their own people, well, they're polite, but they're not polite when they're out on the street. When they're out in the world, they're not polite. Remember what Jesus said? When I was thirsty, you gave me nothing to drink. What people thirst for, of course, is the living water of life, which is found in the gospel. But people don't give that. Oh, we can't talk about God, Jesus, religion. We can't talk about that. Truth in an attitude of love. Jesus is the truth. I was hungry. You gave me nothing to eat. What do we want to eat? Well, we want to eat the table, the food that the Lord puts on the table for us. The wisdom that comes from the tree of life. This is the food that gives eternal life. They're not talking about food for your belly. I was naked. You didn't clothe me. What was naked? Their asses? No. Their minds and hearts were naked. We clothe ourselves with righteousness, the white linen of righteousness. We clothe one another in that. We wrap that golden sash around people's chest, the breastplate of righteousness. But people don't. They got people they work with every day of their lives. Never say anything. Never help their neighbor, the person next to them. Hear that good news of Christ come, of truth and love. No one ever takes the time to explain God. Is there any other God but Father Truth? Come on now, think about it. Wasn't truth there before the Big Bang? Didn't truth create the elements? Didn't truth, cause evolution, if that's the way you want to think? Wasn't it Father Truth that did that? Didn't he exist before anything existed? Isn't he eternal? Yeah. It's not hard to identify God. Isn't love the only spirit that gives life? Show me another spirit that gives life other than love. Nothing. Nothing. Just love. Truth in an attitude of love. It makes it so much easier then to be able to talk to people when you understand that. About truth and love coming down in flesh. There's literally hundreds of scriptures in the Old Testament that prophesy about the coming of truth and love in flesh. It's there. Read it. Let him guide you. I was in prison. He never came to visit me. Can the mind and heart be in prison? The body is free. We go where we want. Say what we want, do what we want. But can the mind and heart be in prison? In a dark, deep, dark, dank dungeon? Nobody listens to them? Nobody takes the time to hear their side of the story? Nobody gives them a sip of water? A little grain? A little bread? Put a shawl over there. Shoulders. They're spiritual shoulders. And the people say, Lord, when did we not do all of these things? We gave you water. We gave you bread when you were thirsty. Water when you were thirsty. We dug wells all over Africa. We gave you bread. We sent grain to every part of the world. You know, we opened our doors and fed the poor guy on the street a hamburger and everything. Those are good things to do, but that's not what God's asking you to do. We clothe you. I mean, come on now. Look at all Sally Ann and everything else, you know, and all the stuff we give away. And we had prison ministries, Lord, that were just unmatched. Yeah. Not what he was asking you. He was just asking you to love. To love God. Enough to search for him and find him. And to love whoever crosses your path. Give them what they need to survive death. To participate in the resurrection of the dead. Give them what they need. Show them. Will many of them turn against you and persecute you? Sure. Don't worry about that. Keep going. You're not done. There's 7 billion people out there. You're not done. Keep going. But get ready. When the whore catches fire, everything that you thought you knew may be burned to a crisp with her. Come out of her. Come into Jesus. You hold that Bible close. You read it. You pray and ask the Lord to give you understanding. He'll give it. Of that I guarantee. He will give it. The dots will start connecting immediately. But we all have free choice. And it is our choice to live or to die. It is. Jesus has provided the sacrifice for the forgiveness of sin. But if you won't come and take that sacrifice, you die. And that's your choice, not mine. Lord willing, we'll see you again next week. God bless you all. Jesus is Lord. Love one another. Bye for now.